recognized symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
Welcome to the Superstars of Wrestling, coming to you this week from the Braun Civic Center in Huntsville, Alabama. One of the city's most famous facilities is the Alabama Space and Rocket Center, which happens to be the world's largest space museum and the home to NASA's United States Space Camp. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Superstars of Wrestling at ringside. This is Vince McMahon, along with wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino, and, of course, a graduate of the Space Camp, but in a different way, Jesse the Body Ventura.
That's because I'm always flying high.
Some would say that. Yes, indeed. We're ready for action. We certainly hope you are as well. Likewise, an individual competition. And then batten down the hatches for tag team action. Here come the Islanders, along with the Ultimate Warrior. All of those and more, but right now, let's go up to ringside.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from San Antonio, Texas, weighing 232 pounds, Omar Atlas. And his opponent...
Oh, no.
By his manager, Colonel Jimmy Hart, and escorted by his girlfriend, Peggy Sue, from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 247 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man!
The Honky Tonk Man!
McMahon, can't you just visualize me on piano right now?
Yes, what did he refer to you as? Jerry Lee Ventura?
No, Jesse Lee Ventura. He's my middle name.
Look at this. Honky Tonk Man.
And you know, the fun thing was, Oakland waited around and got the results of Honky Tonk and us won. We were the winners at the Slammies.
No, that's not the way I heard it. Not the way I heard it at all. Is now, look at the Honky Tonk Man. Preparing for the matchup.
Well, remember, only Sika knows for sure.
That's true. Bruno, what do you think of the vocal performance of the Honky Tonk Man at the Slammy?
Well, I thought, I got to be honest, as much as I don't like his tactics and so forth, the way he's conducting himself as a champion, but darn it, he was pretty good.
Actually, I thought Jimmy Hart was quite good with girls in cars, although he got his come up and cut for sure. Strikeforce walking away with all the lovely young ladies.
You know, how come you don't rave about Peggy Sue the way you do about Elizabeth McMahon?
It's easy.
Yeah, it sure
it's
is.
It's easy. You don't find her attractive?
I don't find her unattractive, but I hardly don't find her...
I understand the fact that she dresses like the 50s and you're a product of the 40s, so I can see where there'd be a relation problem there.
No, I just don't think that Peggy Sue has the character and has the integrity. Not to mention the beauty. Honky Tonk jamming the elbow down. Macho Man had a word to say about this Friday night. Here's what he had to say.
Ooh, yeah, this Friday night. This Friday night is when it happens, yeah. When it happens, yeah. It's when Elizabeth becomes the manager of the new Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion. Yeah, this Friday night.
That is going to be something, yes, one of three title matches this Friday night. Of course, Strikeforce defending the tag team championship against the Hart Foundation, and the big one we've all been looking forward to since WrestleMania 3 way back in last March. Andre the Giant
against World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan. And I don't know, for one, with Ted DiBiase in the corner, that concerns me.
Why? In what way would it bother you to have DiBiase in the corner? You think he'll interfere?
Anything can happen. There's a shake, the rattle, and there's a roll. Honky Tonk on Omar Atlas, and he gets a three count.
Now you notice the Honky Tonk doesn't pick up Omar Atlas and do more damage to him. He got the pin, clean.
Peggy Sue in there, twisting and shouting along with a Honky Tonk Man. Don't tell me he's going to play the guitar.
I hope so.
Here is your winner, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you very much for being a lawyer. Thank you. Thank my girlfriend, Peggy Sue. Thank you, man. I love you.
Don't be cruel. You can bet the match. You can bet the Macho Man is going to be cruel come this Friday night. Let's take it out, ladies and gentlemen, to the Outback.
From the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, here's Update with Craig DeGeorge.
Hello again, everyone. Friday night, this Friday night, live from Indianapolis, Indiana, you will have the opportunity to see one of the great cards in World Wrestling Federation history. Three titles on the line, live nationwide television, broadcast time, 8 p.m. Eastern. More now on the matches. Strike Force will defend its tag team championship against the former champs, the Hart Foundation. This, of course, a rematch from their bout in October, a bout that saw the title change hands on a submission to this day Jim the Anvil Neidhart still denies. Also for the Intercontinental Championship, the Honky Tonk Man defends against the Macho Man, Randy Savage. And when you think about the matchup, certainly that ugly sequence of events is brought to mind, referring, of course, to their last nationwide meeting.
What jeopardy she placed herself in, just trying to protect Randy Savage. And there with that vile creep, Rebecca Tarr. Oh, no! Oh, no!
Elizabeth shot down to the canvas by Honky Tonk Man standing over her. Look at that. What humiliation. But at least she saved Randy Savage. That's all she wanted to do, and she's done a good job of it.
The Macho Man, of course, will have all the incentives in the world as he battles Honky Tonk for the Intercontinental Crown Friday night. And, of course, also on tap, World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champ Hulk Hogan against 7'5", 525-pound Andre the Giant, their first battle since WrestleMania III. First matchup one-on-one, that is, because, as you may recall, the Giant did manage to intervene in one of the Hulk's matches a few weeks ago.
The music playing, Hulk's controlling Andre from behind. Headbutt by Andre.
Look at the look. Look at the look on Andre's face. He's tugging the Hulkster. Look at this. I can't believe it. Hogan looks helpless to me.
Andre trying to choke the life out of the World Wrestling
Federation. What are you talking about trying to choke it? He is choking him down. Look
Hulkster
at Hogan.
Coming back up. Hulkster on his feet. Down goes Hulk Hogan.
I can't believe it. Hogan looks helpless. Look at how small Hogan looks next to the size of Andre the Giant.
You know, there is another vital point here. That is Ted DiBiase's recent purchase of Andre the Giant's services, which could result in the Million Dollar Man actually being handed the heavyweight championship should the Giant win.
This Friday night. This Friday night, Andre, it all comes to pass. Everything that I said would happen will happen. All of you people out there said that you didn't have a price for the Million Dollar Man. And then I showed you, each and every one of you, that you did indeed have a price for me. And oh, you, Hogan, you thought that you would be the exception to the rule. But no, I told you, by hook or by crook, I always get what I want. And I want the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight title right here. And this is the hook. This is the hook that's going to deliver it to me. Andre, tell him what you're going to do.
Hulk Hogan, this Friday night, I just want to make this man happy. And I will do it, Hogan. I will grab you and finish it the squeeze I started. And then when I will know is enough, I will pick up the belt and deliver the belt.
You see it, Hogan? You see it? It's mine! It's mine!
All right, this Friday night, three title matches live on nationwide television at 8 p.m. Eastern, including Hulk Hogan as he defends against Andre the Giant for the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship. Going to be something else. With Update, I'm Craig DeGeorge.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. About to enter the ring, weighing 275 pounds, the Ultimate Warrior! His opponent, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 241 pounds, Terry Gibbs.
Look at the expression of Terry Gibbs. He doesn't know what to make of the Ultimate Warrior. He's going to work on him right about now, though. Terry Gibbs may have been making a mistake here. I don't know. Warrior reversing things, though. Look at that. Yes. Oh, wow. Forget about it.
I think Gibbs figured I better attack first and see if I can injure him from the beginning, and maybe I have a shot. Look at this guy. He's awesome.
He is awesome. 270. Oh, wow. Get that. Oh. Oh, man, they'll be scraping him up after that one. The Warrior. What a number he did on Gibbs. What a chop. Not everyone, I think, though, is impressed with the Ultimate Warrior. We spoke with an individual earlier on who's not impressed.
Step into the arena and have the gall to have the nerve to call yourself the Ultimate Warrior is one thing, but then to step into the arena with the mighty Hercules and have the guts to prove it is another.
Hercules.